Ah, the tangled webs we weave.
Aren't you just tired of boring legendary grenades?
Yeah!
Are you looking to spice it up just a little and try out some much cooler grenades that all have a little twist?
Yeah!
Well, good thing you clicked on this video, because I will be covering 10 purple grenades that you can find easily and that are extremely powerful in usage. I'd say some are even more useful than legendaries. Before I get into them, I'm glad to mention that every single grenade mod on this list is farmable from vending machines. I usually find mine from the arena vending machines, so think the Slaughter Shaft, the Slaughter Star 3000, and the Cistern of Slaughter. So with that being said, I'll just be covering the name of the grenade, and I'll be going over each part of the grenade and what they all do exactly when combined together, as well as covering possible builds that could use the grenade, and the best places that I recommend for them using on Mayhem 4 difficulty. Kicking off the list, I have the Spring Mervtacular Frag Grenade. This is just a kinetic Tediore grenade mod with the following parts. Lobbed, which means that the grenade has a short timer that begins once it impacts something, then once the timer's up, the grenade goes off. Merv, meaning that once the initial grenade explodes, it splits into 3 more grenades, but since it has 2 Merv parts, it instead splits into 6 more grenades. And lastly, jumping, meaning that the initial grenade itself and the 6 Mervs that spawn out from it all jump a single time after their first explosion that deal a final explosion once they land. This totals to a total of 14 explosions, I believe, and it looks crazy cool when it goes off. It reminds me of Bouncing Betty's from Call of Duty. This grenade would go well in a splash damage moze build, but since it's only kinetic, it'd be hard to fit into like an elemental style build. Definitely use this mainly versus flesh enemies like the COV or beast enemies. Next on the list is one that I was actually recommended after my first purple grenade video, and I'm really glad to say that I'm pleasantly surprised with it, and that is the Cloning Maddening Tracker by Atlas. This is a homing grenade mod, meaning that it hones in on the closest enemy slowly after being thrown, and can navigate around objects as needed, but it will explode on its own if it doesn't reach the target after a short time. The other parts on it are divider, meaning that once thrown, the grenade splits into 2 grenades, and each of them still have the remaining parts, meaning that they both have Merv and Bouncy. Bouncy means that once they detonate, they bounce off of the target and then can detonate again. It can do this up to 3 times. Altogether, if the Mervs end up all bouncing the maximum amount of times, this grenade can total up to a crazy 26 explosions. This grenade also really shines in a splash damage moze build because it has the potential for so many explosions, and moze is the queen of kinetic splash damage. Just like the last one, take this mainly versus COV or beast enemies since they mostly have flesh HP bars. At number 3, I have the Cryo Nuke Clusterfuck Exploder made by Torg. This grenade is an exploder, meaning that it has a timer like a lobbed grenade unless you impact an enemy directly, where it would just explode as soon as it contacts the enemy. The other parts of this one are Merv, Mini Merv, which means that each Merv grenade then splits itself into 3 more smaller grenades, and finally the Nuke part, that makes this mod consume up to 2 grenades, increasing the overall damage of it by 50%. This grenade does massive AoE cryo damage that Torg would be proud of.
Yeah!
Since this is a cryo grenade, I have been finding good success with it in Zane builds with Calm, Cool, and Collected, and using an Icebreaker artifact. But if you have a different element, I would try it on Amara since she has high elemental damage builds. This grenade is great versus armored enemies since cryo damage deals extra damage to them, so think like robots and COV enemies with armor bars like in the Slaughter Shaft. Next up on the list at the number 4 spot is a grenade that is probably my favorite on the list, and it's a mixture of the last two grenades that I just covered, and that is the Radiation Cloning Clusterfuck Exploder made by Atlas. It's a homing grenade that has divider, merv, and mini merv, which total up to a guaranteed 26 radiation damage explosions. I love using this grenade with Amara and a high elemental damage skill coupled with atom bomb to just decimate my enemies. It does really, really high DPS for just a grenade, and if the target somehow doesn't die, the radiation effects and the explosions from other enemies will knock it down surely. This grenade does really well versus flesh enemies and even shielded enemies, so think like COV, beasts, Malawan soldiers, and so on. At the number 5 spot, I actually have another cryo grenade, and that's the Cloning Scorched Earth Contact Grenade made by Vladov. It's an impact grenade, meaning that it goes off once it impacts anything, whether that be the wall, the ground, or an enemy directly. This one has divider as its first part, chiller as the second part, and large as the third part. Vladav grenade mods have a neat part that they can come with that spit out elemental burst out the sides of the grenade for a few seconds. This one has chiller after the divider part, meaning that each grenade does cryo damage and chills enemies in the area. The large part just increases the radius of the grenade effect by 20%. And just like the last cryo one that I covered, this grenade does well with the cryo zane build amongst other elemental damage builds. Take this one versus armored enemies like robots, but also versus flesh enemies like human or beast type ones for the most damage. Alright, so we're halfway through our list. Number 6 is going to be the corrosive lingering flurry contact grenade, also by Vladov. This is another impact grenade with rain this time, meaning that on impact, the grenade launches directly up and launches out 3 grenades from it that have the rest of the parts on them, meaning that they also have corruptor and bouncy. Corruptor is just like chiller, but instead it does corrosive bursts rather than cryo bursts. The bouncy on this grenade is a lot different from the other bouncy grenades I have covered because this one just bounces straight up and it does the corrosive damage AoE during the bounces, so the bouncy part gives it a little extra time for the corrosive burst. I've been loving this grenade with my elemental Amara build that uses a flesh melter artifact. If I end up killing an enemy with this grenade or my corrosive weapons, I get a huge power boost to corrosive damage from the artifact. This grenade does best versus armored enemies like robots. Coming up at the number 7 spot, I have the Shock Nuke Spitter Exploder by Torg. This is an exploder grenade with rain, mini merv, and nuke. This one packs a hefty punch and covers a pretty decently sized area with shock damage. The mini mervs rain down after the rain grenades, and each explosion is amplified and does bonus damage. Since this is a shock grenade, running a build with a transformer shield is super strong here because you can fight inside of the explosion area and the grenade will replenish your shields. Again, Amara is my main vault hunter for this grenade because of her high elemental damage, and I'd recommend that you take this against Malwan enemies because they tend to have the most shield bars. Number 8 is another shock grenade mod. This one is the Lingering Mass Recoil Contact Grenade by Vladov. It's an impact grenade, also with rain, but this time with artillery and Tesla. This grenade detonates on impact, then rains down 3 grenades with artillery and Tesla. Artillery causes the grenade to fire bullets out of the sides for a short time, and Tesla does powerful AoE shock damage around the grenade for a short time. If you're looking for a strong shock damage grenade, this would be the one, because it absolutely shreds shielded enemies if you have a strong enough elemental damage build. Malwan enemies will be shaking in their boots with this one. Coming towards the end of our list at the number 9 spot, I have the Radiation Amplified Carpet Bomb Exploder by Torg. This is another Torg exploder grenade and it has merv and rain, meaning that the grenade's first explosion splits it into 3 merv grenades, then each of those merv grenades launch up and rain down 3 other grenades. The last part that it has is link, which gives the grenade a whopping 15% damage boost for each enemy damaged. That's insane! For example, throw this into a cluster of 5 enemies and you have a 75% damage boost as long as it hits all 5 of them. This grenade covers a large area, so make sure to stay clear of its AoE unless you have a red suit shield like this one. Try this grenade with a good radiation build and watch your enemies just go poof. This grenade is best used versus Malwan enemies or enemies with flesh health bars like the COV. Rounding out my top 10 purple grenades list at number 10 is the Incendiary Amplified Mega Fission Exploder, also by Torg. As you can tell, it is another exploder grenade, but this one has large, link, and nuke. If you've been paying attention to the other parts on the other grenades, you can probably tell that this grenade does not spawn any other grenades like every other one on this list. Instead, this grenade just has the one grenade that does fat damage in a single explosion. The link and nuke parts combine to do really good damage, and the large part makes this grenade AoE easy to hit and effective. So while it does insane damage, make sure to stand back far enough or you'll down yourself like I do plenty of times. This grenade actually works very well with every single vault hunter because it does so much damage on its own. This grenade absolutely decimates flesh enemies, so take this into stuff like the COV or beast enemies. That, my friends, is going to wrap it up for my top 10 list of the absolute best purple grenade mods in Borderlands 3. Thank you all so much for watching till the end. Make sure to join my Discord channel to chat with me and my friends every day and help grow this community. If you like the video, please make sure to tediore check that like button on this video because it helps this channel out a ton, and don't be afraid to face slam that subscribe button and rack attack the notification bell so you don't miss out on any future content. Also, feel free to leave me a comment because I'm really good at replying to every single comment across all of my videos. So with that being said, I will check you all in the next video. See ya!